if anyone wants to join, they can.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Okay. So good afternoon, student. So this is a combined batch. Okay. So last class in B2 group, we have gone through the just a brief documentation and brief overview of how the MATLAB programming are done and how the modulation we are doing in the simulation platform. We have just briefly gone through that MATLAB coding part and that simulation part. So in this class, we have gone through in detail regarding that modulation and coding and some simulation. Okay. So directly coming to the topic. Okay. So basically what, basically your modulation means, you are varying some property of your carrier signal in accordance with your message signal. In accordance with your amplitude of the message signal, you are varying some parameter of the carrier signal. Okay, if you are varying the amplitude of the carrier signal, because if you are thinking about any signal in a cosine, in a sinusoidal form, that is a cos 2 pi ft, so it has amplitude part, it has a phase part, also it has a frequency part. If you are varying your amplitude of the carrier in accordance with your message, that is called amplitude modulated signal. If you are varying your frequency in accordance with your message signal, amplitude of the message signal, that is your call frequency modulation. And if you vary your carrier phase with respect to the amplitude, then that is called your phase modulation. That means if you go to the simple and very simple step in the modulation process, so in the modulation, in amplitude modulation, your instant amplitude is nothing but A, which is not a constant, that is AC plus KA times of MT. That means your amplitude will vary, because if you think about only carrier signal, this is AC cos omega CT. In that case, AC is fixed. But when you are talking about the amplitude modulated, that means amplitude of the carrier will modify or vary in accordance with the message signal. That means in that case, your instant carrier amplitude is not constant, and that will vary in accordance with the message signal. Okay, so this is nothing but base equation of your amplitude modulated wave. That means your instant amplitude will be carrier amplitude plus KA times of MT. That means where K is called the amplitude sensitivity. In the similar manner, if I say FM equation, means here the frequency will be changed. That means I can say FIT that is FCT carrier that is carrier frequency plus that is KF times of MT. Similarly, if you go for the phase modulation, same process, your instant phase of the carrier, will be theta C, that means the original phase, plus some modification according to the message, that is KP, where here KF is called the frequency sensitivity, and here is known as phase sensitivity. And if you go through the amplitude modulation part also, same thing I have written, that is AI of T, instant amplitude is nothing but AC plus KA times of MT. Okay, if you observe all these three equations, you can see that if your message, in all three cases, if your message amplitude is more, or you can say message amplitude is positive, you can say your instant amplitude is more. Similarly, if your message positive, in case of frequency modulation, your frequency will be more. And in case of phase, you can get more phase. Similarly, if your message is negative, then you will observe the decrease in the carrier amplitude or decrease in the modulated wave amplitude. Similarly, if your message has negative half cycle, or it is negative, similarly you can see the decrease in the frequency in the waveform, and same case you can found over here. So this is a basic equation. If you want to derive the equation for corresponding modulated equation or modulated wave equation, because this modulated wave equation is necessary to draw the or you can say to draw the block diagram, and this block diagram needed for the simulation purpose. Okay, so according to our first part of this session, first we'll go to the amplitude modulation. What happened in amplitude modulation? Suppose this is a blackboard, this you can say amplitude modulator. What it does, it detects the message, it detects the carrier. As you know that amplitude modulation is nothing but a frequency translation. All type of modulation technique is nothing but a frequency translation. When you are going for the modulation, we are doing the upward frequency translation, that means you are going to higher frequency, and in the receiver side at the other end, you are going the downward frequency translation. So that means for the frequency translation, the in time domain thing but the multiplication. The multiplication will be converted to frequency translation in frequency domain. So if you feed your message signal and carrier signal to the AM modulator, then it will generate your modulated wave. Then how this process were, or what is the things happen inside this black box, that we have to go through. Okay, and after learning this thing, we can verify our block diagram and also simulation. So already from the basic part we have gone through that your SM modulator, that as it is a amplitude modulated signal, that means it just looks like your carrier signal. But what happened here, the carrier is not fixed. Here the carrier is a variable, and that variable is nothing but we have to replace this as AC plus AA times of MT. Okay, that is cos omega CT. Okay, and this MT is nothing but a message signal. Just open it, means that is cos, that is a sinusoidal signal. So take this value, that is KA, that is cos 2 pi FMT whole into cos omega CT. Here I left the value, that is AM. Okay. After that, if you take common AC, if you take common AC, then what will happen? That you will get 1 plus AM by AC, then cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. And this part is nothing but your modulation index, that is your mu is nothing but KAM by AC. And K is the sensitivity, and taking it as a 1, we will get mu is equal to AM by AC. So what is your final equation which you have to implement in your simulation is S modulated wave equation is equal to your AC whole into 1 plus mu cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. And so this is your base equation, and you have to do this, in your simulation. So first of all, step by step we have to go through. So first of all, you have to take this value. First you have to take a sinusoidal message signal, step one. Then you have to multiply with some modulation index, that is step two. Then you have to add this, step three. After feeding this, then all the things will be multiplied with a carrier, that is your step four. That means in a simple step I can say, first you have to generate a message signal, sinusoidal message, then you have to add your index, that both the thing will be fed to your multiplier, because look at the equation, it is multiplied, so you have to fed it to the multiplier. Then whatever the thing is added, that will be given to an adder, that is 1 plus, look, the same thing is done here. So we are at the step 3. After that, you have to multiply the output of this with a cosine carrier signal. and after that we will get the output as SAM. Okay, so this thing we have to do in our simulation.
Plus means?
Plus means just you are adding, adder. This is a signal, this is a signal. We are just adding. Okay, just a mathematical operation, just you are adding. Look this. This addition operation we are doing over there. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Then x means multiplication.
Yes, yes. Cross means multiplication.
Sir, आपने क्या
देखा? Picture. Okay. 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 I'll do it. I'll share with you. No problem. I'll share with you. Later on, I'll share with you. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Then now once you have do this simulation from the modulation index part, we know as it is a mu is a ratio m by ac, so depending upon value of mu, it is of three type of modulation. It may be under modulation, it may be critical modulation, it may be over modulation. What happens under modulation means your mu value is less than 1, means lies between 0 to 1. Critical means mu is equal to 1. Over means mu is equal to greater than 1. Then what happens is under modulation. In under modulation, if you go through the instantaneous value of this, AI is nothing but simple equation. AC plus AA times A times of MT, or this is already updated as cos 2 pi FMT. And you know the maximum amplitude or maximum limit is plus or minus m. So if your message attaining the maximum amplitude, then the maximum amplitude you will get, that is a max, or you can say v max, is nothing but ac whole into 1 plus mu, because this is nothing but 1 plus. And similarly after the getting a max, we are getting a min. A min means when the message will, in its negative half cycle, that is the minimum value is minus 1. So, we will get AC 1 minus mu. So, actually this is nothing but your V max, and this is nothing but your V min. What you should do in your lab, in your offline lab, that is determination of modulation index, that is your V max minus V min. This is the formula what you are using to calculate the modulation index, using your hardware. Okay, so from here only you will get Vmax and Vmin. As it is a online simulation platform, so you have to just put your modulation value and modulation index value, and you will observe the outcomes. Okay, up to this, is there any doubt? Please respond. Up to this, is there any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay, so I am just opening the simulation platform. Okay, so already in the last class I have described all these things, so just I am showing the, okay, this is a single diagram where I have listen, just wait. Already I have done all these things, but let us implement once again for you only. So first of all, you have to, already I told you, first of all you have to give your input like this. So first you have to, means these are the three parameters. First you have to select a source, you have to select a modulation index value, generally it is a constant. Again you need another constant, you need another that is a multiplier device, another adder, this is a adder, again this is a multiplier, again you need a source. Okay, you need this thing from your library, and you know how to drag all these things from a library. So this is a library file. You can drag it over here also. Otherwise, just on the simulation window, just give a left click. And the if you just click the left click, you will find a search window. And in that part, you should type your module, what you need. Suppose I need a source, so I need a sinusoidal source. Just I type the sign, and already it will give it will do the search for you, and just click it. So I will get a sinusoidal wave. Clear? Then okay. First I have to check all the condition. I have to take amplitude 1. Okay, this parameter you have to set. As it is a message signal, so a low frequency you have to let it hype, and you have to give a sample time, and it should be very less, not 0.00. Okay, up to this we have generated the input signal. After that, we need the mu, that this part we need. That is your modulation index, which is a constant value you have to provide. So just I am doing this modulation part. After this, you have to do all these things by your own. Just then, just click the value that is because you need a modulation index that is a constant, and just give a value to 1. Okay. Then I need a adder. Sorry. Then I need a multiplier to multiply those things. This is not. Okay. Is a product. So just you will fill this value, or like this. That means you are at the step mu cos 2 pi fmt. Then after that one will be added. If you go through the equation, one will be added, that is constant. So, and for that I need another adder. So, like this only you will do all these things. Adder, okay, add. Okay. It's okay. Again, after that, I need another product because all these things will be multiplied with carrier. So, whatever the result over here, that will fit to a. And we need another carrier. But the thing is that you have to modify your parameter of that carrier. Okay. Okay, that means as it is a carrier, so frequency should be more. Okay. And okay, everything is okay. Then okay. Apply. So whatever the output comes, this is nothing but your amplitude modulated wave. And if you want to see this, you need an oscilloscope. Sorry, that means an oscilloscope you need. So just type scope and you'll get that one. Just connect to it. Okay. So look what we have done. First we have fed the input message. Then 1 plus, then we have given some mu. This is nothing but your index, modulation index. So this part is nothing but mu cos 2 pi fmt. If you go through this, that is nothing but mu cos 2 pi fmt. That is mu cos 2 pi fmt. Then what we have done? Then we have added 1 to it. That means 1 plus mu cos 2 pi fmt, like this. Look this part. 1 plus mu cos 2 pi fmt. Then after that, we multiply the whole into AC cos 2 pi fmt, means a carrier signal, which is nothing but this carrier signal. And already this is sine, we have to make it cos. So after converting into cos, if you want to verify, just run it. First of all, I run it. Okay. And if you want to see the outcome. This is nothing but your amplitude modulated wave for mu is equal to 1. If you, sir, you will told that, sir, why this is a modulation index, this is the observation for modulation index 1. Why this is observation for modulation index 1, you have taken as this as 1. And accordingly, you have to set your carrier amplitude and message amplitude. Suppose you want to test for a higher higher modulation index, let's say I will take it as 2. Let's say I will take it as 2, okay? By simply putting at 2, nothing will happen. You have to edit it, because your modulation mu is nothing but AM by AC, and AM by AC is equal to 2, means AM is twice of AC. So what AC you are feeding, just check it, carrier wave, that is 1. So your message amplitude should be twice of that. So just make it 2, apply, now just run it. See it. Okay, so this is over modulated case. Okay, so if you so now come to this model. So in this module I have designed all the three things. So just compare it. Just I have run it. Look at, so this upper part, look, we are feeding modulation index 2. We are feeding modulation index 2, means over modulation case. So let us check. Already the file is shared to your CS. So you just go, first of all, you do by your own. If it is, if you are finding any difficulty, then ask. If after that, if you are unable, then run that code. Okay, so this is only for your reference. So the upper one is your message signal, then carrier, then this is your over modulated case. Okay, similarly, if you go to the because up to this we have done, that is your modulation part. Then this section is called demodulation. Okay, if you go to the demodulation section, so amplitude demodulation is up to, means three techniques are there. One is your envelope detector method, another is your, that is and most probably you are using this method is synchronous detect. Okay, just wait. Just wait for some time. I just drink some. Okay. So generally we are following three methods for the demodulation case. So one is square law demodulator, where we are using a nonlinear device. Then another method is envelope detector. And another is synchronous detection. What happened in envelope detector? In envelope detector, we are just, after getting the modulated wave, after getting this modulated wave, we are just detecting this envelope, this outer boundary. Okay, so we are feeding some diode, then capacitor, like this thing. All these things is in your theory. If you have any doubt, you can ask at any time. Okay, in square law demodulator case, we are feeding your that is your modulated wave to a nonlinear channel, nonlinear device. After that, we are feeding that to a low pass filter. By feeding these to a nonlinear device, we are doing the downward frequency translation. After that, we are just separating the low, that is low frequency component. And in what happened to the synchronous detection, in synchronous detection, remember, whatever carrier signal you have used in the modulation case, that carrier frequency we are feeding as a part to the, or as an extra parameter to the receiver part, and that frequency is utilized for demodulation, okay, which you which we have used in this technique, that is synchronous technique. That means whatever the modulated signal we get over here, the same modulated wave is taken, along with that we have taken the carrier signal. Look, this is a carrier signal. From carrier signal we have taken one input and another input from modulated wave. This multiplication is done means we are doing the downward frequency translation. After doing this downward frequency translation, then that is passed through a series of filter. There is a low pass filter. This is the transfer function of that low pass filter, because if you go for the transfer function of the low pass filter, that is nothing but 1 by 1 plus, that is nothing but we are getting over here. That is 1 by, that is some constant value we are getting, S plus R. So if you take common, that will be 1 by, if you take 15 as common constant, so you will get all the time constant, that is R and C. Because that transfer function is nothing but 1 by 1 plus S tau, okay, that is a general form. After, if you simplify it, that expression, you will get 1 by S plus this expression. So this is just just a value we have taken, that time constant frequency like this. So after this, you will get the output. Okay, you can take the different R and C value and implement over here, and you can check the different combination. Okay. So this is a demodulated wave, and this is a comparison. Okay.
And wave, how are you getting?
Sorry?
From which option are you getting with the wave?
Again, please repeat.
Sir, how to get the wave from which option?
How to get wave from which option means how to bring that sine signal? That thing you are asking. Okay. You are on the screen now.
Yes.
You are on the screen now. Now you are running your MATLAB or not?
Yes sir.
Okay, just give a left click and you will get a search button. Is it fine?
Sir, where left click?
Any point in this whiteboard, at any point, just give a right click. It is a shortcut. Otherwise, go to this is a right, this is your library file. You can go to this library file, then it will generate a dialog box. In that dialog box, you have to search wherever written is as source. But simple technique is just give a right click on anywhere in the screen. Ye jo white ke screen hai na, at any point, just give a right click.
Sorry?
Right click. Explore.
Right click.
Can you share your screen, please? I'm stopping my. Okay, just wait. Look, this to come. Once you click on the library, this type of window will come. Is it correct? Are you getting this type of window? Hello? Hello?
There is, sir.
Okay, then there is a source. Look, there is a source. Just click it. If you go down, there is a source. Are you getting?
Sir, I am sharing my screen.
Okay. Then, if you want to share, then okay. Just click on Simulink. Yes. It will take some time. don't be hurry, it will start, okay, create a blank model, okay, good. Everybody please go through the procedure. Don't think that you will collect the file from your friend and run it. Do it by your own. If not possible, then you can manage it. But first of all, you have to do on your own. Okay, after this, just come to the white screen. Okay, just give a right click. Any point, just give a right click. Right click, not left click. Right, sorry. Left click, sorry. Extremely sorry, just give a left click. Just give a left, single click, not double, just give a single click. And wait, single click and just wait. Okay, now a symbol is coming. Just type it, just type it, just type it. Don't click anything, just type it. Type it as sign. Simply type, okay. S-I-N-E, just wait. Then there is a written a toolbox, there is sign symbol is there, just click it.
Sign wave.
Yes, just because you need a sign, just click it. Just wait, it will come. Don't be hurry, it will come. Okay, in this manner, whatever the module, adder, constant, oscilloscope, everything you will bring. This is one of the shortest method to add the module in your model. Otherwise, you can go through the library file, which is under a square box on the left side of that setting symbol. From there also, you can add your device to the model. But the easiest method is just give a left click, and in the search bar, just write whatever device you want. Automatically, it will search and show you the same file, and just whatever file you need, just click it and add it. Okay.
Adder also.
Just click add, not adder. Just click add. Okay. Then we'll get it.
First option.
Yes, first option. Okay. Similarly, you can get oscilloscope, everything. Is it fine to you?
Yes, sir. How to modify the frequency?
Just double click on sign. While I presenting my screen, what you have gone? You are just give a double click. Here you have to modify. You can modify your amplitude. You can modify your frequency. You can modify your sample time. Anything you can modify. Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then close. Is it okay? Or any doubt?
Yes, sir.
Anyone? It's just I am going through the simulation waveform. So this is the input part, means we have the input signal, carrier signal, and over modulated signal. And while we go on through the which part, demodulation case. So this is the message signal, and this is nothing but your demodulated signal. Okay, and simultaneously, if you go through the other section, means this part I have done here, what I have taken, modulation index 1. Modulation index 1 means your mu is equal to 1. Mu is equal to 1 means your AM by AC is equal to 1. If you go through also, look, my carrier signal also 1. My message signal also 1. So you have to take care of that. By writing only 1, 2, that does not mean that you will get over-modulated case, you will get under modulated case. So you have to maintain the same thing in your amplitude of your message and carrier part. Same thing, whatever we have done in the previous case, same thing you are feeding message, then this is your modulation index, then that you have added with one, then
sir,
you have
given, sir, your screen what? Share isn't on.
Sorry. You should inform me.
Sir, actually, we were confused. Actually, what happens is that we think that maybe our end is there is a problem. So,
no. Okay. What to say? Now it's okay. Now it is okay?
Just a minute.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that is the earlier we have shown the case of that is over modulation. So here we have taken index as 1, so that is a critical modulation. Okay, don't think that if you write 1, write 2, so that will give you corresponding modulus. So you have to maintain the thing same in the parameter also. Look here, carrier amplitude 1 and message amplitude also 1. That means your AM by AC, that is 1 by 1, is nothing but 1, and that 1 we are fitting as a modulation index. So same thing is as you see in the block diagram theory part, the same thing we have added. And this is the input signal, this is the carrier signal, and this is your critical modulation. In that critical modulation, what we have gone through, you know, in the critical modulation, what happened in your critical modulation, you know that mu is equal to 1. So mu is equal to 1, what do you mean by mu is equal to 1? So your maximum amplitude is nothing but AC whole into 1 plus mu, that is nothing but 2AC. And what is your A min, or that is nothing but your B min according to your manual. That is nothing but AC, that is nothing but 1 minus mu, that means 0. That means your B min is 0. B min is 0 means, so if this is your 1 and 1 part, this is another envelope, this will touch. Okay, the same thing we are getting over here, like your theory. Is it correct? That means this is your B max and this is your B min, which is 0. Okay, and if you go to the demodulation case also, where it is. Okay, we are getting the demodulus. Same thing, you have to go for a synchronous detector. That means you will feed your modulated wave and carrier wave. Then that will pass through a series of filter, low pass filter, then you will get a demodulated signal. Same thing, if you go to your, that is under modulation. Look here, the modulation index is 0.5. 0.5 means 1 by 2. That means your AM by AC will be 1 by 2. That means your carrier amplitude will be twice of the message. So just verify it whether it is actually there or not. Carrier amplitude, look, this is 2. That means denominator is 2, AC is 2. And look at here, 1, that is nothing but 1 by 2. That means 1 by 2 is nothing but 0.5, correct with the modulation. So same thing, just I am verifying the scope output. Look, this is your message, carrier, and this. And you know, in case of under modulation, you will get some non-zero Vmax value, non-zero Vmin value. So this is your Vmax. So due to that scaling, it is just it is not able to show this part. But actually, if you go through a single diagram, you can see this part. So this is your Vmax and this is your Vmin. Okay, if you want to go through also single part, also I have one connection. You can see it over here. Okay, this is your Vmax. This is your Vmin. Okay, so for this same demodulation technique, same thing is there. That means whatever the modulated wave and your carrier will be fed to a multiplier, then series of filter, you will get a demodulated wave. Okay, so this is the thing you have to go through on your own. Okay, up to this, is it correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then just go, whatever you did in this part, means in the simulation part, the same thing is there in the coding part. Coding part means, look, means you have gone through your experiment, that is multisim experiment, VHDL experiment. What you have done in multisim experiment? In multisim experiment, you have dragged the components and you are getting some output. Okay, but what in the VHDL? In the VHDL, you are not dragging, you are writing down the logic. So the same thing is here. Your simulation is nothing but like your multisim, and your this editor window is just like your VHDL. Okay, so you have to, whatever you are doing over there, that thing you have to code it over here. Okay, so in this coding, I have just comment what is the meaning of, or what is the significance of that code. Just go through it and run it. And you know how to run it. In the last class also, we have discussed how to run this code. Okay. So in every step, I have mentioned what is the significance of each line. I think nobody will face difficulty. Okay. So in every line, I have commented what is the significance. just go through it and run it. Okay, up to this, is it clear? Please respond up to this.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, just for observation purpose only, I want to just run this code. Once you run this code, what it is written in the fourth statement, that is you have to give your modulation index as input. Okay, so an input window will come, means user input line will come, or you can give your modulation index, just wait. So my system is slow, that's why it's taking some time. Then you will get some modulation index value. Let's say I'm giving 1 for critical index. Then it will run and generate the waveform for you according to the code you have written. Everything. Okay, look this. I want to zoom it. Okay, look. This is your input message. This is a carrier. As the frequency is very high, so that's why the signal is not visible, because time separation is very less. And look at this signal. That is your this signal. This is your modulated signal. And look here. That is your Vmin is zero, as already you have discussed in the simulation, also in the theory part, and this is your demodulation. Okay, so like this you have to do the FM also. For the FM part only, just I am going through the equation. Okay, just wait for another 15 minutes, it will be completed. So if you go for the frequency modulation, already what I told, in case of frequency modulation, these are instantaneous amplitude is nothing but your carrier frequency have some variation with respect to that message. Yes or no? So if this is the value, from this you have to generate your, that is your FM wave equation. So your FM wave equation is nothing but like this. It should be like this. But this is not a constant. Now this will vary like this. Okay, and you know that this is nothing but your theta. That is your phase. That is theta. So you know that theta is nothing but omega t, and you know that is omega is nothing but 2 pi f t. Very simple step. But you want to know what change in the variation of theta will happen with respect to variation of f. So you have to express that is d theta by dt is nothing but 2 pi f. Up to this, is this clear or any doubt? Please respond. Is there any doubt?
It's clear.
Okay. Just wait another 15 minutes. Don't be hurry. Just listen patiently. Okay. So then you have to click. Sorry. Then d theta, you have to find that is nothing but 2 pi f dt. And if you take the integration both side, you will get theta. Then theta I is nothing but 2 pi f I t. So this thing, that is nothing but your change in or your modification in frequency, how it affects your phase. So this thing you have to put over here. Okay. And again I'm writing that part, that is theta is nothing but 2 pi f I t. And in this f I part, this is f I nothing but f c plus, that is kf times of mt. Just if you put all this value, and then you will get your modified FM equation will be, that is ac cos, as it is like this, but inside that you will get the frequency as like 2 pi fct. Look how it is written, 2, because 2 pi inside f, you have to put all these things as 2 pi fct,
plus plus 2 pi kf integration mt. Okay, and this is your original equation, which or required equation, which you have to implement over your simulation window. Okay, and to make it more simple, because same 2 pi is also there, same 2 pi is also there, so why to multiply it two times? So better take it common. So so finally the equation will be AC cos, then inside cos what will be there? Inside cos there will be 2 pi, then FCT. So for FCT you can write FC integration from minus infinity to t dt. So this will be FCT plus, this is 2 pi common from both sides, that is nothing but kf, okay, by 2 pi. Okay, so integration m up. And this thing you have to implement. So how you do? First you have to give them same. First you have, this is your step one, you have to give your message. Okay, then message will multiply with some constant value. Then that will be integrated. Then you have to give a integration function. Integration function means you have to use its transfer function. You know if it is an integrator, its transfer function is 1 by S. If you go through the signal system or S transform means procedure, you understand that if it is an integrator, its S domain transfer function is 1 by S. So you have to feed an integration over here. Same thing. You have to give a constant, because this frequency is nothing but a constant. You have to give it. After that, whole thing will be multiplied by some another constant, that is 2 pi. And finally, all these things will be given to a cos, means a cos trigonometric function. And finally, you will get the SFMT. So just I am showing you the part. Are you understanding all, or is there any confusion?
So it's clear.
So same, we are according to the expression, look, the expression where I have written. Okay. So first of all, we have given a message signal. Look, the message signal is here. Then the message signal is multiplied by that some constant, that is nothing but k by 2m. We have taken this as a constant. Let's say this is 50. There is a modulation index for fm. If you go to the theory, you can understand it as very well. Okay. So after that part we will do, you will also provide some constant, that means this value, that is voltage. like this. These two pipes you have to provide. And then we have to take integration as a whole. Why to take integration two times? Just put a single integration. Okay. So this is nothing done in the program. So we are feeding a sinusoidal wave. Then we are feeding that 2FC part. Then after that, whatever the addition, that is integrated. And this is an integrated transfer function. Then that integration is multiplied by 2 pi. Already I told you in this part, we have to take the common 2 pi. In this 2 pi will be multiplied with the whole integration. The same thing is done over here. The 2 pi is multiplied. Then the entire thing is applied to a cos trigonometry function. Because whatever the thing up to this, will be the argument for this cos function. So cos of the entire thing. Okay? This cos of this entire thing will be nothing but your, but if you go to the equation, cos of the entire thing is your FM wave. Okay? So look, this is your FM wave. Just I'm running it. Just look. It's compiling.
Sir, you can use Alt plus Tab to easily switch between windows.
Okay. Okay, so compilation is over, I think. Okay, now compilation is over. Just I have to see the output. Look. So this is your output waveform, and if you go to the part, just wait, it is here, let's see. Okay. So look, look this section, this is your message amplitude. This is your original message signal, and this yellow is called your modulated wave signal, that is FM modulated wave. And if you go to the theory, what I have told, when message amplitude is more, frequency is more, message amplitude decreasing, frequency is decreasing. You can see that in this section. In this section, you can clearly see that your message amplitude is increasing, means positive. So your frequency also increasing. Look, the gap is very less. And while you go to this section, this half cycle, you will get the amplitude is decreasing. As amplitude is decreasing, so you can get the frequency is less, frequency will also decrease. The frequency will decrease means time gap is more. Again, this cycle, message amplitude is increasing. This is plus. So plus, because if you go to the equation, you know that that is your FIT is nothing but FC plus KF times sub MT. When your message amplitude increasing, frequency also increase. When message amplitude decrease, frequency will decrease. So in this section, message amplitude decrease, message amplitude decrease, message amplitude decrease. That's why frequency also decreasing. Frequency also decreasing. So is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Fine?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So already you have to do this experiment also. So, and the same thing as I told you, whatever you will do in the simulation, the same thing you have to do in the coding part. Same editorial window is there. same code is there, but instead of modulation, instead of amplitude modulated, you have to do your frequency modulated. And one thing I left over here, that is one thing, just to explain that part only, that is the demodulation section. So this is nothing but the demodulation section of the FM wave. Okay, so as you are using a frequency modulation, so in the frequency modulation, what is your general equation? Your general equation is nothing but AC cos theta IT, and inside this theta your message is there. And if you want to demodulate this message, you have to reach up to this. That means here there is two technique. Differentiating means you have to make it derivative so that you will reach at the slope part. Then you have to go for an envelope detector. Another method is phase log loop. In phase log loop part, we are generating the modulated wave signal with locally generated modulated wave. Then the system will generate some error for you. Look, if you go to the figure, okay, this modulated wave, this is the modulated wave you have taken from the modulation simulation, and that will be compared with some locally generated modulated wave, and it will generate some error. This error continuously feeding back to the system, so that error will be zero. Once you get error will be zero, you will get the modulated output. This is the simulation. Okay. Is there any doubt? This is nothing but your low pass filter. Because if you go to the theory section, so this is. But only three pictures are there. Just I have to show that one, then I will close it. Only three pictures are there. Okay. So this is your PLL. This is the PLL method part here we are using. Okay, it has three parts. One is VCO. This is nothing but your VCO. Where it is? Okay, you'll find it later. Okay, this is a VCO. Because the modulated wave, first it enters to the multiplier, then the output is fed to a loop filter, then the output of loop filter will provide it to the VCA. Then the VCA output will fed to the multiplier, then it will compare some output. Okay, likewise, this thing will be carried out. Till you are getting error is zero. Till you are getting error zero or more nearer to zero. Okay, and when this condition will satisfied, you can verify that you are perfectly demodulated the FM modulated wave. Okay, I will share this picture also. Then already I shared the simulation file. If anything you need, you can contact me. I can share or I can help, but one thing is important. You have to do by your own. You should not take any help from others. You can ask me, okay, but you have to do by your own. You don't copy the simulation everything from others. You have to do by your own. Okay, if you have facing any difficulty, just ask me to your CR, just ask me or take numbers and just ask me, sir, we face difficulty here, there, any part. Okay, we are here to guide you, not to just take the class. Okay, we are here to guide you and you are there to do. You have to do and we also have to guide. Okay, when you think like that, then you can say your education is perfect. Okay, so
sir,
Swaraj, sorry, please ask the question, anything.
Sir, I have to learn, we have to click Ctrl plus P.
You can take any shortcut key, no problem. There is some standard shortcut key, somewhere it is F9, somewhere it is Ctrl plus anything. So you can use, that is not a big thing, okay? Hello?
Sir, to listen, then run.
Sorry, I didn't get you. What you are asking?
To run this diagram, we have to go for simulation option, then run.
Yes, that is whenever you draw any figure or any blocks or any okay. blocks. Okay. After that you have to click on the run symbol. Here there is a run symbol, look. Once you finish the block, this is your run. Is it fine?
Sir, here?
Here only.
Sir, I am clicking.
Are you able?
This one.
Are you able to see? This green color symbol, you have to press it. Once I press it, automatically in the background, it will compile and it will show, after some time, it will give some beep sound. That means your compilation is over. Then you have just click it. Yeah, so that you can see your web or simulation, whatever. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Swagatika ma'am, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Ma'am, for attendance, what should you do?
Sir, I have already taken the attendance.
Okay. So, shall you wind up this session or any doubt from student? Please respond. Is there any doubt?
No, sir.
So today we have completed that AM simulation, FM simulation, along with their MATLAB implementation. Is it fine with everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir, whiteboard that is also the key.
Kuta, sir? Kuta?
Whiteboard is a...
Not audible clearly. Please repeat.
Sir, whiteboard ephemera, what is the screenshot name?
Don't worry, I'll share scanned copy, okay? Don't worry, I'll share all these things. Okay, don't take this is just a rough one. I'll share with you, okay? I'll share. With a good handwriting, need not to be any. So I'll share all these things with a scan file, okay? Just for rough purpose, I have done this. I'll share the handwritten copy or handwritten scan copy, okay? You didn't install MATLAB?
Yes, sir. MATLAB code.
Okay, already I said with your share. The MATLAB code already I shared with your share, just call it from me. Okay, Shubham, sorry Shubham, Swaraj?
Yes, sir.
Okay, please share the MATLAB code and let the student to run it, and if they face any problem, then we will discuss, okay?
Sure, sir.
Because every line is commented, means what is the significance of that code, already I have mentioned. If students are getting any trouble, then we'll discuss again that part, okay?
Sure, sir.
That is in extra time, okay? That is not in the lab work, in extra time, okay?
Sure, sir.
Okay, so for this timing being, we have completed these three sections, okay? That is
yes.
AM simulation, FM simulation, and MATLAB simulation of FM and AM. Okay. For experiment. Okay. Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Swagatika, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
So, we should stop here?
Yes, we should stop here, but Swaraj, inform your group B1 students to attend the lab tomorrow.
Sure, ma'am.